A lot of people have been tipping me off to this story and asking me to cover it. Well, here we are. Let's take a look. Let me, of course, also thank you all for the news tips, and also thank GameWizard02 on Twitter. If you're on Twitter, check him out if you would like, at GameWizard02. Of course, he did a wonderful write-up on Nianet about this situation. I'll leave a link in the description if you want to see all the images and all the information in one spot. For now, though, I'm going to go right to the tweet, and let's read. A Chinese company. By the way, this is Jacob, the founder of Fakku, who says, a Chinese company named Shenzhen Guangcai Trading has trademarked the word Ahegao while using stolen artwork and is trying to get Fakku to stop selling the only 100% official merch. We are going to fight it, but please stop buying the bootleg items, legit versions, in the replies. Now, hey, just being honest, I'm sure I'm going to be on Jacob's side on this one, but I still have to point out the only 100% official merch thing does sound a little odd to me. When we're talking about a dispute about owning the Ahegao trademark, seems kind of odd to write that. But he does explain, for example, what he means. He says, the classic Ahegao shirt, we teamed up with the artist at Victim Girls to make the only official version in the world. So I'm going to assume that's what he meant by only 100% official merch, but I would strongly, you know, caution wording things like that, phrasing things like that. Kind of comes off like you're saying you're the only vendor, the only company that can sell actual Ahegao merchandise, which definitely rub people the wrong way, in my opinion. Let's move on. Okay, now we're taking a look, of course, at the actual trademark search for what's going on here. You can see the records, the word mark Ahegao translation. But actually, before anything else, let me point out the date, because this was actually apparently this trademark from this Chinese company, Shenzhen Guangcai Trading Co. This was actually filed on September 19th, 2018. And I think that is extremely important, because why are they just now going after Fakku in the middle of 2020 when they actually filed for this trademark back on September 19th, 2018, published for opposition on February 5th, 2019. I'm blocking that. Let me scroll a little bit for you. You can see that right there. So I think the first thing we need to do is to try to understand what exactly they're doing here. And I have some theories on that. We'll be right back to that, though. Let me give you the rest of the information at the top. So they say, translations, the wording Ahegao has no meaning in a foreign language. That's questionable, putting it lightly, very lightly. Goods and services. Caps being headwear, coats, corsets, corselets, other types of clothing. So you gotta question, what exactly are they trademarking here? Are they just trademarking the word Ahegao, like literally the word on clothing? Or are they actually trying to trademark the facial expressions? That's something you might need to question them in the court of law, or not exactly in court if you have your attorneys settle out of court and discuss all this stuff. That's something that you might want to raise the issue on, in my opinion, because obviously they're just trademarking the word. That's kind of funny, and I don't think they'll get much of that. Now, yes, they do have the image right here, but listen, I'm not an expert, but I will still confidently say, that's not how this works. You don't just get to describe something in text above and then post an image and be like, yeah, also that, by the way, also this. We're also trademarking this. So that's just my opinion. So why are they doing this? Let's go back to the date thing. September 19, 2018. Here's my theory. I don't think this company actually has any legitimate plans, in my opinion, legitimate for this word. And the reason for that is, well, I looked up this company, and I don't see them selling any product or service at all, let alone related to this trademark that they're trying to go and use. So if they actually, you know, for example, filed this in 2018 and started releasing merchandise with it and that sort of thing, it would be a different situation, excuse me. But that's not what's really going on here. What's going on here is it looks like they are kind of just trying to do what's called copyright trolling, so to speak. Again, this is trademark. It's a bit different than copyright per se. But I think what they're doing here is they saw this thing getting more trendy and popular, this terminology, Ahegao, and they trademarked it, knowing down the road they might be able to enter litigation, or more so threaten and scare, you could even say extort, if you want to go that far, smaller companies, maybe, basically bully them and see if you can sue them. But ideally, like I said, I don't think they would expect this to go all the way. I think what they would try to do is basically bully, extort, however you want to put it, in my opinion, smaller companies, and try to force them to pay some sort of payment and settle out of court. Basically, they trademarked this to try to get money on the legal front. I don't think they actually have a legitimate use for this from what I've seen. That's what I'm getting at. And that's why I think they filed it in 2018 and they've just been sitting on it. They filed it then, they've been sitting on the term, letting it get more trendy and more popular, and now they have chosen to strike against Fakku. And here we are. In closing, I'm going to leave you with this. This is pretty interesting, and you can find more information on this part of the topic, well, the whole topic in general too, but especially this part on nyannet.com. I'll link it in the description once more. GameWizard02 writes, "As a result, both Western and Japanese fans have come out in droves to show their support for Fakku. I'm going to scroll past these. If you want to read them, you know where to find them. And I want to show you something really interesting, though. At the end of the article, he says, one Japanese Twitter user pointed out that the same Chinese company may have also registered another trademark for Ahegao in Japan as well. Now, obviously, I can't read Japanese, so I can't confirm this myself. But if that's really the case, interesting stuff. If there's any updates on the situation, I'll do my best to cover it. You know, if this ends up going to court, we might see some legal documents become public. But if you've been following the Vic lawsuit with me, you know that's very time consuming. So don't expect like a lot of updates. We'll see where this goes, though. Maybe we'll cover this again in the future. And I look forward to catching you then. Take care.